So far, we have seen the geometric construction that allows us to find the square roots of natural numbers, but it was a recursive process. That is, to know the square root of a given natural number, it was necessary to know the square root of the previous one. Now we are going to look at another construction which is more powerful and direct as well. So it will allow us to find in one step the square root of an arbitrary number, say 3.14. This is based on the geometric property of similarity. Similarity is nothing but scaling, either scaling down or scaling up, of a geometric figure. For example, here we have a triangle and we have scaled it up by the factor, say 1.5. And then once again, we are going to scale up by the same factor to get this third triangle. Now, if we take the corresponding lengths of these three triangles, say these green lengths, 16, 24, and 36, then they bear the same ratio and therefore they are in proportion. So to say 16 is to 24 is 24 is to 36. Such triplet of numbers is said to be in geometric progression, and the middle number can be had as the square root, as shown here, of the product of the first and last number. So 16, the first number, multiplied by 36, the last number, will give us the square of 24. And that's the root we can take to find square roots. Now, such triplets in geometric progression can be had using right angle triangles. So we'll start with this one over here, and we are going to rotate it so that this base of the triangle comes and aligns with the height of it. Then we are going to scale this copy that we just made about this point so that the height of the copy becomes the same as the original. So now we have two right angle triangles which are necessarily similar because they are just rotated and scaled, and they have the same height. Now the base of the this triangle, then this height, and the base of the original triangle will be in geometric progression, because this base upon height will bear the same ratio as this height upon this base. And therefore, the product of these two bases will give us the square of this height. Now, how does that help us in finding a square root? Well, imagine a situation where one of these bases, say this one, is equal to unity. And in that case, the height will be the square root of this base. Let's see how. So suppose we want to find the square root of, say, 3.14. So I'll draw a segment of length 3.14 units, then extend it with a collinear segment of 1 unit. These are the two bases. One is unity and one is the number whose square root we want to find. Now we want to construct this larger right angle triangle whose hypotenuse is this compound segment. A quick way of constructing right angles with a given hypotenuse is to use that hypotenuse as the diameter of a semicircle, because the included angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees. Then from their junction, we'll be drawing this line, which is going to contain this height here, and then trim it up to the circle, and we are actually done. But just to make it look like our previous figure, I'm going to construct these two lines, and under the circumstances, we can get the square root of this red length as this yellow length. Let's actually measure it. This is 3.14 because we plotted it so, while this is 1.772. This should be the square root. Let us check if it is indeed so. I'll punch in 1.7720. Square of that is giving us 3.14. So this is the way we can obtain square roots. Now, these three triangles that we constructed have a strange connection with an interesting ancient tool called the arbelos. An arbelos is a cobbler's knife, and if you look at its blade, you would realize it is made up of three semicircles really. So there is this large one, and from which these two smaller semicircles of half the size are subtracted. When Archimedes saw this, he was absolutely fascinated, and he quickly did two things that mathematicians like to do. Number one, he generalized this shape by making these two smaller semicircles of unequal size. And number two, he started thinking about properties of this shape, like its area. So the area is shown in blue, and this is how Arbelos is related to the triangles that we had constructed. And Archimedes came up with a very impressive statement. He said that if you draw a circle whose diameter is given by this height, then the area of this circle is equal to area of this Arbelos. Let us see how we proved that. We have already seen that area of a geometric figure is proportional to any of its linear dimensions. So we can express the area of this larger semicircle in terms of its diameter a plus c squared. Of course, multiplied by some constant factor, which will filter out because it's going to be there for all our expressions. Well, so this is the area of a larger semicircle. From it, let us subtract this semicircle of diameter a. So I'll subtract a squared. Then the second semicircle I'm going to subtract, so minus c squared. Now, algebraically speaking, this is the expansion of a binomial a plus c squared. So if you subtract a square and c square from that, you'll be left with only 2 times ac. This a into c is the product of these two bases, which we have already shown to be the square of this height. So this expression 2ac will be equal to 2b square. And this b square will be the area of this green semicircle, because b is diameter and there are two of them. So that makes the whole of this green circle. And thus Archimedes showed that the area of this Arbelos is equal to area of this circle. This is called Archimedes' Lemma.